Jim, bruh, dude, I'm gonna be ripped. I'm gonna be diced. I'm gonna be shredded wheat. No salt for me, bro. I'm serious. Well, that is fitting a backfire, and here's why. Hey, Jim Schultz here for F-Cubed and livefcubed.com. Man, leaving no stone unturned in all things fitness, finance, and faith. So if you're brand new to the channel, man, toss me a little sub action before we get started. Today's video is going to help you guys learn a little bit more about an unknown player when it comes to sodium and water balance, when it comes to what causes water retention, aldosterone. Having spent so many years as a competitive bodybuilder, man, I have learned all about sodium and bodybuilding. I mean, let's call it, you know, bloating bodybuilding. And we talked a little bit about this in the first video, where we took a look at some of the sodium nutrition facts and kind of like the sodium myth, if you will, where we said, you know, if you're an athlete, when it comes to sodium for athletes, a low sodium diet, a low sodium intake probably doesn't make a lot of sense. And so give that guy a look if you missed it the first go around. Now today's hero, aldosterone. Now this little hormone inside our bodies, it doesn't get all the glitz and glamour that testosterone or cortisol or insulin get, but man, is this guy ever important, especially if you walk around feeling like a water balloon. So what is aldosterone? How does aldosterone work? Well, basically this little guy is a hormone that is produced by your adrenal glands, which sit right above your kidneys. Now aldosterone, amongst other things, basically controls how water and sodium are excreted from your body or reabsorbed back into your system. Now what is super interesting is the fact that aldosterone basically has an inverse relationship with your body's ability to rid itself of excess water. If aldosterone spikes, that sends a signal to your kidneys to reabsorb sodium back into your bloodstream. It also sends a signal to your sweat glands to reduce the amount of sodium that they lose through your sweat. So what can cause aldosterone to spike? A low sodium intake, which might seem pretty counterintuitive, but it actually makes perfect sense if you stop and think about your body's main objective. Your body's main goal is not to get ripped. It's not to get diced. It's not even to get shredded wheat. It's to survive. So if you don't give yourself enough sodium, if you don't feed your body enough sodium through your diet, like we talked about in that first video, it's gonna conserve sodium whichever way it can, because your body needs sodium. It requires sodium, so your aldosterone spikes, you end up clinging on to every water molecule on planet Earth, and you feel all ooey, gooey, and marshmallowy. Three feelings that no gym warrior ever wants to feel. So ironically enough, a low sodium diet that's aimed at cutting water could end up completely backfiring. So what should you do? Don't be afraid of salt, man. Don't be afraid of a high sodium diet. Don't be afraid of high salt intake. If you're an athlete, like we talked about in that first video, this will not only boost performance, but you're probably gonna be a whole lot healthier and a whole lot drier. Appreciate you guys for taking the time to check us out today. You guys know the drill, man. Like, share, subscribe. We'll see you guys next time.